So, with your kind permission, let's start. Good morning to all of you. I, Dr. Jitendra Jain, welcome you all in the first session of fourth day. And it's a great privilege for me to welcome Professor Sunil Dutt sir, professor in the Department of Education and Educational Management at NITTR Chandigarh. And he is going to deliver his expert talk on blended learning and flipped classroom. He has conducted various training sessions in the field of educational technology, curriculum development, education and educational management, management, personality development, research techniques, methodologies, soft skills, entrepreneurship development, ICT-based education, and teaching learning using free open source and social networks. Sir, we are grateful to you for accepting our invitation as an expert in this FDP. So, such a very experienced and resourceful expert is with us. So, I welcome you, sir, again and request you to kindly start the session. Over to you, sir.
So thank you, Dr. Saab, and good morning, dear participating teachers. So at the very outset, I extend my sincere thanks to Engineering College Bikaner for giving me an opportunity to interact with the participating teachers. And the theme of the course is a wonderful one. And in that theme, they have kept one session on blended learning and flipped classroom. So friends, we all of us have been employing lecture as a mode of presenting instruction in the classroom. And this method has been criticized by many educationists, teachers, administrators on a number of platforms. You see, lecture method, you see, generally the teacher pours the information into the minds of the students without interaction. Maybe I cannot say that all the teachers do not involve student interaction, but many a times we do not, you see, interact with the students. We simply pour the information into the minds, into their minds. So with the result, the students remain passive in the classroom, and in case they have some doubts, they cannot ask for further information clarification. And all of us know that every day, thousands of teachers deliver the exact same lesson in class to millions of students. And every night, millions of students sit over the exact, you see, same homework, trying to figure out how to solve it. So, as I said, that this method has been you see, criticized because it has got number of limitations. You cannot gain the attention of the students. Many a times the teacher cannot, you see, or cannot integrate media in the classroom. He is simply teaching the abstract information in an abstract way. So concretization is not possible. So the blended learning is a new method of providing instruction that is turning the traditional classroom on its head. So traditionally, you see, students listen to lectures and take tests in class and read textbooks and work on problem set at home. So you see, in the blended mode of learning, what we do, we provide some part of the instruction through online mode and remaining part through an offline, you see, mode. So this session is about, you see, blended learning. Friends, you know that we are living in a time when things are moving fast, the rules of game are changing, science is changing, technology is changing, and even the world of work has also changed. But our students are, you see, for the most part, still constrained by traditional transmission models of learning. As you all know, and we have been witnessing, that today's students grew up with internet access. YouTube, Facebook, MySpace, WhatsApp, Telegram, and a number of other digital resources. They can typically be found doing their homework while texting their friends, iming on Facebook, and listening to music all at the same time. The use of the traditional learning approach, which focuses on the teacher as the center of knowledge, friends, is irrelevant in today's digital age. So today the role of the teacher is to facilitate learning. The role of the teacher is to create an environment in which students actively participate in the process. So as a solution, the traditional classroom activities like lecture or laboratory work or sometimes the homework examination can be moved to the web 2.0 technology, and student can study everywhere outside the classroom. Okay, so blended learning has been highlighted as an emerging technology, and the second theme is flipped classroom. So flipped classroom is one form of blended learning. So friends, let me tell you that even the new education policy, that is 2020, focuses on the digitally equipped institutions, students, and teachers. NEP 2020 believed in holistic, multidisciplinary approach to bring flexibility in education system. Basically, it gives importance to technological innovations for enhancing teaching learning experiences and transforming regular classroom based pedagogy. Friends, recently University Grant Commission has constituted a panel, and that panel was constituted to improve the quality of teaching learning in higher education institution. And the panel has suggested that the institution should follow or should employ blended learning for imparting instruction up to 40% teaching, that is via online mode. So and rest of the 60% can be through offline mode. So blended learning is a blend of both online world and classroom teaching learning process. You see, the UGC had decided that higher education, as I told you, higher education institutions should be allowed to teach up to 40% of each course through online mode, and remaining 60% can be taught in an offline mode. And the draft report of UGC said that the advantages of blended learning, including flipped classroom, for students include increased learning skills, greater access to information, improved satisfaction and learning outcomes, and opportunities both to learn with others and to teach others. So blended learning as such is not a mere mix of, you see, online and face-to-face mode, but it is a well-planned combination of meaningful activities in both the mode. That is, teacher has to prepare a lecture plan also. So the blend demands consideration of number of factors, focusing on learning outcomes, learner-centered instructional environment, and so on. So while defining the role of teachers in blended learning, UGC had said that blended learning shifts the teacher's role from knowledge provider to a mentor and a coach. And this shift doesn't mean that teachers play a passive role or a less important role in students' education. You cannot replace teacher, okay? So teachers can have an even more profound influence and effect on students' learning. Now you see, if you look at one survey which was conducted by Kaiser Family Foundation on 8 to 18 year old kids, and they have reported very astonishing facts that 6 hours 21 minutes the kids spend with media per day. 26% of the time kids, you see, they use more than two media simultaneously. 3 hours 51 minutes they spend on TV video per day. 1 hour 44 minutes they spend, you see, on music per day. 1 hour using computer other than for the classroom work, for the school work. 49 minutes they play video games. 43 minutes they play recreational, you see, reading. The students, to them, computers are not technology. They indulge in multitasking. Okay, and for them, reality is a meaningless term. Now they are more and more towards the virtual environment in which everything can be possible. If you look at the successful learning, what does it constitute? It includes that successful learning is possible if the students remain active throughout the teaching learning process. And this is possible only if we employ blended learning and flipped classroom. You see, in a traditional classroom, teacher delivers the lecture. Sometimes, you see, with some PPT, but majority of the time without PPT, without involving their participation, without asking questions, without responding to students' questions. Okay, so in this case, now good videos, e-contents are available, or the teacher has developed the e-content or recorded the video and uploaded the uploaded in the website of the institution. Students can download, or even the teacher has identified a good video from YouTube portal and provided a link to the students. Students can watch that video inside the classroom. You see, very good videos are available on YouTube, ranging from 1 minute to 1.5 hour duration. So the role of the teacher is to identify good videos, because the experts of those videos, they have used good, you see, infrastructure, PPT, or you see, or other actual practical experiences they are provide. So such type of experiences are liked very much by the students. So they actively see to those video. And you see, in a flipped classroom, which is the reverse of traditional classroom teaching, what is happening in traditional classroom teaching? You see, the student listen to the teacher's lectures, and you see, carry out homework at home. But in flipped teaching, students first study the topic by themselves, because the teacher has provided them e-content or video. They study at home, and when they come to the classroom with preparation, they actively participate in problem solving exercises. So that is active. Another is that contextual. Lot of meaningful examples are given to the students to associate the abstract knowledge with real life experiences. Students, they are engaged totally. And successful learning is the result of interaction with the teacher, interaction of one student with the other student, interaction of student with the media, and so on. And you see, no student wants to work alone. So in a blended mode, we are giving them some problem solving exercises in small groups, so they learn better when they teach each other. Okay, now if you look at the learning pyramid, you see we tend to comprehend only 10% of what we read. Say you are reading the e-content, but in case you have got some doubt, you cannot seek further information or elaboration. We understand only 20% of what we hear in the classroom. That is, when the teacher is talking to the students, students are simply hearing. But when the teacher is explaining the concept with examples from their daily life, then they would listen to it. So there is a difference between hearing and listening. Listening involves active active, okay? Listening is with understanding. And 30% of what we only see, that is when the teacher shows a picture or he shows some movie or display some exhibit, and 50% of what we both hear and see, okay, 70% of what we say when the students are involved, and 90% of what we both say and do. So models for learning, firstly it is the classroom learning, where we employ a traditional we give a lecture by traditional method. The teacher is talking to the student, and the number may be 20, 50, 100, 500, and mainly it is face to face. So teacher is delivering instruction. It can be in a small group or it can be in a large group. Another is the e-learning using computer technologies. So through e-learning, we provide online tutorials, sometimes the simulations, games, online testing, and we have got some audience response system. If we have developed some learning management system, digital learning environment, and the student presence is only online, not in the classroom. This is only e-learning, okay? They are learning while sitting at home or while sitting in the playground, anywhere. Mobile learning again, learning using mobile devices like laptop, smart iPhone or iPad. And here you see the focus is on synchronous and asynchronous communication. You see, synchronous communication means that there is a real-time communication between two people. It can be either face-to-face, or it can be through phone also. And synchronous communication needs clock signal between the teacher and the student, and the data transfer rate is very high. Whereas in case of asynchronous communication, this doesn't require clock signal between the teacher and the student, and the data transfer rate is very slow. So both we focus on both types of communication. Then we have got models for learning. This is mobile learning. This is the now need of our blended learning, that is combination of face-to-face learning, e-learning, and mobile learning. So there are different types of delivery formats, different forms of communication, and there are didactic models which I'll let you know after some time. What are the various models of blended learning? Now the question is e-learning better than face-to-face? I think e-learning is equally effective, but as far as imparting knowledge, skill, or behavior is concerned, but more effective, that is if we employ blended mode of learning, that is where the students learn something themselves, and in case they have got some clarification, they can seek more information from the teacher when the teacher explains the concept with examples or describes the procedures. So e-learning will be more effective when it is blended with the traditional mode of learning. So to address these needs, we try to open up class time for active learning strategies. But how do I do and still provide the same coverage of the content? So blended learning is very essential, friends. So it is the new flower which has blossomed in the area of learning technology or educational technology to support teaching learning experiences. So as its name implies, it is the blend of, as I said, it is the blend of online resources as well as traditional resources. And usage of blended learning is growing increasingly in the educational context because different methods significantly help in enhancing academic performance, learning outcomes, student satisfaction from the learning experience. Blended learning, you see, is a term which is used to describe the way e-learning is being combined with traditional classroom method, or you can say hybrid. So blended learning, hybrid learning, technology mediated instruction, web enhanced instruction, web quest instruction, mixed mode learning. These are some of the terms which are being used interchangeably in the research literature. Actually, the focus is one that is blend of the online and offline mode of delivering instruction. If you look at the Oxford Dictionary, it has given a very beautiful meaning of the term blended learning. That is a style of education in which students learn via electronic and online media, as well as the traditional face-to-face teaching. So it means it is likely your students are already doing some form of blended learning and have for years. So as digital and social media become more and more prevalent in the life of learners, actually it was only a matter of time before learning became, you see, blended by necessity. And you know, all know last year what happened because of pandemic. We teachers have, you see, adapted ourselves to impart instruction through blended mode of learning. So blended learning is the deliberate fusion of the online, which is both synchronous or asynchronous, and face-to-face contact time between the teacher and the student, or between the students in a course. So this has been promoted and encouraged in an increasing number of higher education institutions. This is, you see, an approach to education that combines online material and opportunities for interaction online with traditional, you see, place-based classroom method. It requires the physical presence of both teacher and student, with some elements of student control over time, place, path, or pace. You see, you have developed e-content that you have uploaded on the website of your institution. You have also recorded a video by using even your own mobile camera, and also uploaded that video on the. Now, the students, they have control over the pace, okay? They can read the e-content again and again. They can watch the video again and again. Whereas in case of traditional lecture, the teacher is teaching sometimes at a very high rate of delivery. He's imparting instruction. And there are variety of students sitting in the classroom. Some students are slow in you see picking up the material. So through this mode, students can learn at their own pace. And if the e-content contains inbuilt प्रैक्टिस टास्क क्वेश्चन फॉलोड बाई फीडबैक, देन जिसको बोलते हैं सोने पे सुहागा. तो ई कंटेंट शुड बी डेवलप्ड बेस्ड अपॉन द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ सेल्फ लर्निंग मटीरियल. आई विल गिव यू द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ सेल्फ लर्निंग, द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ सेल्फ लर्निंग लेटर ऑन. सो ब्लेंडेड लर्निंग, यू सी, इट इज अ मेथड ऑफ टीचिंग दैट इंटीग्रेट्स टेक्नोलॉजी एंड डिजिटल मीडिया विद यू सी ट्रेडिशनल टीचर लेड क्लासरूम एक्टिविटीज, गिविंग स्टूडेंट्स मोर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी टू कस्टमाइज देयर लर्निंग एक्सपीरियंसेस. यू सी, वाइल क्लासरूम टीचिंग लर्निंग ऑफर्स एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर रोल प्लेइंग विद इमीडिएट फेस टू फेस, ऑनलाइन लर्निंग ऑफर्स यूजिंग पर्सनलाइज्ड सेल्फ पेस्ड लर्निंग विद ई लर्निंग और मोबाइल लर्निंग कंपोनेंट्स दैट लेंड देमसेल्व्स टू इंटरैक्टिव मीडिया लाइक स्किल बिल्डिंग गेम्स, वीडियोज, ट्यूटोरियल्स, क्विजेस, सोशल मीडिया कंपोनेंट्स. ऑल दीज कैन बी एक्सेसिबल बाई द स्टूडेंट होम पेज if there is a learning management system, and this can also be accessible from the student's smartphone or iPad or tablet. So in general, I would say that blended learning refers to some learning which happens online in a format where the student has control over the path and pace and at which they engage with the content. Some learning happens in a teacher-led classroom. So online and in-person learning is complementary, creating a truly integrated learning environment. Many studies I have found in the literature, and studies have shown that blended learning, you see, reduces failure rates, improves learning, and boosts the student engagement. This blended learning combines the best aspects of face-to-face teaching and online instruction in ways that enable students to learn at their own pace. For example, a student in a blended learning course who masters a concept earlier than his peers can move on without having to wait. And on the other hand, a student who needs more time is not forced to move forward before fully grasping the content. So it is proving to be a scalable learning model that simply works for diverse population of students. You all know that we find students with varying learning styles in the classroom. So blended learning is not simply mixing technology and teaching. It is it includes a mix of both face-to-face teacher-led instruction and online or digital course component that gives students some control over path, over pace. Blended learning is not completely an online course or a lecture course that is broadcast online, and it also does not include course changes that simply swap analog tools for digital ones. You see, in blended learning, the in-person and online elements work together to create a richer learning experience and do not simply duplicate course content in varying formats. And I told you that flipped classroom is a type of blended learning. I'll throw light on this flipped classroom later on. I'll focus only on the blended learning right now. There are variety number of blended learning tools and resources available, like Google Classroom. We have got YouTube, Zoom, Microsoft Teams, Skype, Moodle, Blackboard, WebEx, okay, etc. Students doing face-to-face group work in a classroom, then going home to analyze that work and turn in a video as an assessment form, taking a course you see online, then receiving face-to-face tutoring between online lessons. Blended learning has, to a greater extent, met the needs of various types of learners. Some learners learn better in a structured environment, and independent types learners better with semi-autonomous or computer-based training. Now, the question is, why blended learning? You see, in the past decade, teachers at higher and even lower education institutions have, you see, organically adopted blended learning as a meaningful learning tool in and out of classroom. And let us have a look at the benefits of blended learning. Firstly, because people are no longer single method learners. So you have to employ multiple method, and that too learner centered active learning strategy you have to employ. And blended learning is one form. That is, you are giving them e-content, you are giving them videos, you increase your contact time with students through this mode, because you are not focusing on imparting, you see, lecture in the classroom or giving notes to the students. Many a time the teacher only dictates from its notes. Okay, now this part is already given to the student, so they can study themselves. शुरू में हो सकता है दिक्कत आए कि भी स्टूडेंट जो है वो हाउ वी कैन इंश्योर कि भी ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स हैव लर्न द मटेरियल देमसेल्व्स ग्रेजुअली दे विल पिक अप एंड दिस हैज हेल्प्ड टू इम्प्रूव द एबिलिटी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट टू पर्सनलाइज लर्निंग बिकॉज द मटेरियल इज प्रोवाइडेड टू देम इन स्मॉल स्टेप से ई कंटेंट इज देयर small steps followed by inbuilt questions followed by feedback. Once he masters the first component, only then he will move to the second input of the lecture. So they can read the material again and again if required. They can watch the video again and again if required, and keeps learner engaged with the use of variety of content type. Okay, from passive learning to active learning, reading, speaking, listening, thinking. And there is a potential for, you see, individual progress. Jaisa ki maine bola that it has met the need of various types of learners. So every learner, each learner in the classroom has a unique learning style and unique requirement. So blended learning takes every type of learner into account, whether they prefer the familiar traditional classroom, okay, would learn online or try a mix of both. So blended learning employs a variety of methodologies, so the content can be customized to the learner and optimized for the subject matter. Learning trends and feedback. So blended learning uses online and offline technology, allowing teachers to quickly adopt the latest learning trends and modalities into the curriculum. So teacher can use built-in reporting features of the LMS if there is a LMS with them software. So you see, for learners, blended learning offers the unique opportunity to discuss, to model, to practice their new skills. So they are not just watching or hearing, they are doing. So by applying the new knowledge shortly after they have left the physical or virtual environment, learners can retain the knowledge for a longer period of time. And it also has helped in lowering the cost, such as travel cost, accommodation cost. देखिए, I'm delivering this lecture through online mode. अगर मैं वहाँ आके देता, then Engineering College Bikaner would have to reimburse my traveling, and they have to bear the charges for my accommodation. So वो सारा cost जो है वो reduce हो गया. Initially, teacher has to spend some time for the development of e-content or recording of the video. But in subsequent years, their time will be
Hello, Sunil sir, are you there?
Sir, I think yeah, he is there, but unmuted bhi hai sir. To I think call karna padega sir shayad. To ek
bar call kijiye.
Yeah, please bar call kijiye. I think sir has left and he'll be joining.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. He was busy on call, sir.
Okay, right? Okay.
I think he got some urgent call.
It is requested to all participants that remain seated in the classroom and have some patience.
Thank you, Dr. Sandeep, for kind words.
Sorry, there was some computer network problem. So please
okay, sir.
Make me the presenter once again.
Sir, I have assigned you that privilege. Hope you got it, sir.
Nahi, abhi nahi mila.
Sir,
on
now
my side, it is showing, sir.
Now it's okay.
Sir, okay. You have been logged in from two names, like, so now it is given to you.
All right.
Yeah.
That is good.
So we were on this point that it has lowered the cost. You see, अगर मैं आपके आके यहाँ लेक्चर देता देन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज बीकानेर हैज़ टू बियर माई टी ए डी ए और यू सी अकोमोडेशन चार्जेस सो दैट कॉस्ट हैज़ बिन नाउ मिनिमाइज एंड इवन इट हैज़ ऑल्सो रिड्यूस्ड द टीचर्स टाइम फॉर डिवेलपिंग द मटीरियल अगेन एंड अगेन वंस the material e-content has been developed or video has been recorded, the teacher can use again and again. And another is that a lot of fun and engagement, because blended learning is an interactive experience. Learners, you see, reinforce the offline lesson by practicing online through a variety of different content media, okay, and reach and personalization is to a larger extent. And let me show some of the research studies who have favored the use of blended learning instruction. I have taken all these from literature, that blended learning results in improvement in student success and satisfaction, as well as in improvement in student sense of community when compared with face-to-face courses. Blended learning was found to be effective in addressing diverse learning styles. Blended learning provided learners with greater control over the pace of learning, instructional flow, selection of resources, and even time management. Now let us have a look at some of the models, blended learning models, and see if they might work for you. You see, when you are teaching a diverse group, it is almost impossible to tailor the learning experience to suit every learner. So a blended learning model can help you personalize your subject matter for time consideration, learning techniques, several personal preferences. But implementing a blended learning model requires some changes to how the way you think about training or teaching. So one is face-to-face blended learning model. This is a traditional teacher-led learning session supplemented with technology to allow students to control their own learning pace. So you see, e-content is available on website, or video is available, or you have provided them through email or WhatsApp. They can study at their own pace, and in case they have got some clarity, they want some doubt, they have got some doubt, they can seek information or clarification from the teacher in the classroom through face-to-face. That is face. This is the best model as far as I am concerned. Rotation. This is nothing but flipped classroom. That is, material is provided to the students. They go home, they study the material at home, and then they come to the classroom for seeking clarification. That is rotation. Third one is flux. Flux learning is a term that can be used interchangeably with personalized learning. By accessing means of integration of learning in an LMS, learning management system, the students can control their learning path, they can choose what they want to learn. The teacher is present in a mentoring capacity to answer the student's question. This is one of the most effective ways to motivate students by letting them play. So by using gameplay elements like points or levels, students feel a little competition and are more motivated to experience the material on their own time. Then another is that online laboratory. So this blended learning model is entirely digital with little, or I would say no, teacher interaction, and takes place either before teaching, during teaching, or after teaching. Learners can access content on mobile phone, laptop, tablet. So this modality engages learning and solidifies learning. Self-blend learning is a kind of supplemental content. It is either in the form of webinars, blogs, video tutorials that help self-motivate students go deeper into a subject. And if you have got a very robust learning management system, so that can combine diverse content sources under one system to encourage the curiosity and growth on the part of the learners. And there is one online driver. This is entirely self-directed and takes place in a digital environment. So learners can engage with the teacher through some chats, email, or some message board. This model provides a flexible schedule, personalized learning, but lacks face-to-face interaction of other types of blended learning, because this is mainly a LMS. Now, how to implement blended learning? You see, as a teacher, you need to prepare a lecture plan. So first of all, you formulate your blended learning goals in advance. Then combine online and face-to-face instruction, that is, prepare a lecture plan, what part you will be giving to the students through online mode, which content you will be covering through offline mode. So define the learning outcome, because this course is on learning outcome. So specify how and when to use technology. You have to prepare a lecture plan and create learning activities that offer the best of both the worlds. And the basic components of blended learning include self-paced e-learning. That is the e-content. Self-paced means that the student can learn at their own pace. It is in small steps. Language is interactive, very simple language. Lot of illustrations are given in the e-content. Even some sources for or resources, web resources are also given in the e-content. Some links are given to the in the e-content. The student can study more information by accessing to various web links given in the e-content. Face-to-face instruction is another component. Mobile learning and social learning, including blogs, online discussion, WhatsApp groups, all these are the main component when virtual classroom teaching. Now you see, there are number of issues or challenges related to blended learning. Though blended learning approach appears to be master of all teaching learning methods, but it is not an easy task to implement, because this approach has its own pros and cons. Number of problems and challenges have been faced by the teacher as well as by students while adopting it. And many research studies have indicated that the major challenge of blended learning include time management on the part of student, increased workload on the part of teacher, course design, there are some personal barriers, there are some career pressure, and so on. So let us have a look at these. One is that it is to some extent an expensive digital resource, because to use the technological resources, the institutes have to increase their budget, and time to time maintenance of these digital resources is again an expensive affair, and not every institute can afford to apply this approach for their students. To use and apply the blended learning approach, so adequate skill and competency is required by the teacher as well as by the students. So while using this approach, the teachers may many times do not know about the basics of using it in the real classroom. So that is why it has led to sometimes disaster. And sometimes the teacher resists to the use of technology simply because it is available. So this is another drawback. More focus is given to its implementation and very less to its proper designing of the content. So there is inadequate instructional content. Teachers, you see, forget to prepare a lecture plan on what to teach rather than how to teach. So all the elements must be well blended. Some of the online assessment are subjective in nature, consisting of several personal reflection. So issues related to assessment. Sometimes students do not view the advanced content, view the content in advance. So such students, they lag behind on the course. So in blended learning, the learner must be competent enough to handle the online content himself or herself. Here the teachers have to prepare both the ways, online as well as offline content. And this has increased the workload on the teacher at the initial stage. I'll say initial stage because you are developing e-content and video, but later on your workload is minimized and you are focusing more on student interaction in the classroom. And sometimes the unavailability of teachers during online session, and sometimes the content is outdated, that is the teacher has developed material 5 years back. Now, same is being, so you need to update your content on a regular interval. So now let us have a look at the strategies or the suggestions for gaining the benefits of blended learning. And let me give you one suggestion. You are teaching one subject. Okay, what you can do is you can do a small experiment. Identify five topics from your subject that you will not be teaching through lecture mode. You have developed e-content for those five topics. You have also got the video recorded for those topics, prepared one quiz based upon those five topics. Now, divide your class into two subgroups randomly. To one group, you will not be teaching through lecture mode, that is, you will be exposing the students through blended approach. And to the other group, you will be teaching the same content using the lecture mode. So after the experiment is over, give the test to both the students, and then you compute the data using T ratios. You will definitely come to know which method, students of which method got higher scores, and you can write paper and send the paper for publication. So the suggestion is that, as I said in the beginning, that working with blended learning approach is not an easy task. So a teacher must always get proper training beforehand. A training will help the teacher how to effectively integrate online with face-to-face instruction, so that the student can see the connection and your subject does not become a course and a half for effective blended learning. Balance between online and offline content, as UGC has also suggested, 40% up to 40% through online, 60% through offline. So teachers should challenge their students, but also create a balance in the instructional demands. In blended learning, teacher plays a very important role in delivering blended learning instruction. So they need to create some kind of balance between online and face-to-face content by not giving more focus only on one aspect of the content. Then orientation program. So before implementing the blended approach in the classroom, the teacher should always start with an orientation to the students to avoid later problems. So student must be given some information regarding the outcomes, the benefits of the approach, website to be used, availability of resource material, schedule of the class, so that they get themselves familiarized with this new approach before using it in real settings. Not every student is familiar with the digital resources being used in blended learning method. So it is the duty of the teacher to provide important tips regarding the study and time management skills to the students. As I told you that you need to develop e-content. So you need to split the larger content into smaller sections containing inbuilt practice task question followed by feedback, so that students can engage themselves in activities which require higher order thinking skills. So this means content needs to be simplified. And you can also give focus on discussion strategies. There must be an interactive and productive discussion between a teacher and a student. So classroom time must be for the content, you see, discussion. And discussion strategies, you see, may include web discussion, think, pair, share, show and tell, brainstorming, and so on. Now I'll move to the other part, that is the flipped classroom. Now, flipped classroom model. So what is typically presented in the class, that is the lectures, content, background knowledge, or real life by a teacher, students receive the content via a reading material, e-content, self-learning material, computer-assisted instruction material, or YouTube video, or other online resources. What is typically given as homework is done in class with the assistance of the teacher. So let me first of all relate flipped classroom with pedagogical theories. An educationist, Allen, he has looked at various pedagogical theories and examined their applications to the flipped classroom. And these theories include Vygotsky, Bloom, Keller, Skinner, kuch naam aapne sune honge. And Allen has tried to give a very concise introduction to each theorist fundamentals, and he has tried to apply it to the flipped classroom. Firstly, it is the Lev Vygotsky, who was a Russian psychologist and proposed a theory of the development of higher cognitive functions in students that saw reasoning as emerging through practical activity in a social environment. So his theories emphasize that students can reach a higher level of understanding through group work and that is the main component of flipped classroom. Whereas lectures emphasize conformity and memorization, group work emphasizes problem solving and knowledge application. क्योंकि फ्लिप क्लासरूम में स्टूडेंट ने घर में इंडिविजुअली तो पढ़ लिया, लेकिन क्लासरूम में ग्रुप्स में दे विल कैरी आउट प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग. सो ये जो रशियन साइकोलॉजिस्ट है, इनकी थ्योरी को फ्लिप क्लासरूम में अप्लाई किया गया. एंड देन कम्स द ब्लूम्स, बेंजामिन ब्लूम, हु वाज एन अमेरिकन एजुकेशनल साइकोलॉजिस्ट, एंड ही हैज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू द थ्योरी ऑफ मास्टरी लर्निंग मॉडल. So this theory stated that students must master prerequisite material before moving on to learn subsequent information. So here the focus is on the time required for individual students to master any given information. So as such, students receive individual instruction, they work at their own pace, they receive regular feedback, क्योंकि e-content में स्मॉल स्टेप में इंफॉर्मेशन है, देन इनबिल्ट क्वेश्चंस हैं, फीडबैक है, और स्टूडेंट दे कैन स्टडी एट देयर ओन पेस. सो दीज आर ऑल द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ फ्लिप्ड क्लासरूम. देन कम्स केलर, अमेरिकन एक्सपेरिमेंटल साइकोलॉजिस्ट हु डेवलप्ड द पर्सनल सिस्टम ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन. सो अगेन ही हैज लेड एम्फेसिस ऑन मास्टरी लर्निंग. Okay, so he developed the plan, breaking down the larger content into smaller content, which is what flipped learning tends to do. So the student must demonstrate mastery of the content before moving on to the next unit. So these are the key components of flipped classroom. Skinner, American psychologist and behaviorist, who developed theory of reinforcement and radical behaviorism. So reinforcement was applied to sequential learning, and that is once the student completes the first part, answers the question, gets the feedback, so he gets reinforced, he moves to the next. So that is these are the five theorists on which the flip is based. So a flipped class is one that inverts the typical cycle of content acquisition and application so that students gain necessary knowledge through e-content, self-learning material, computer-assisted instruction material, video before class, and teacher guides students to actively and interactively clarify and apply that knowledge during class in solving problems. So it shifts instruction to a learner center model in which time in the classroom is used to explore topics in greater depth and create meaningful learning, while students are initially introduced to new topics outside of the classroom. E content bana hua hai, video padhi hui hai, you have given to them on their WhatsApp number, or you have uploaded on the website of your institution. They can download, they can study, and content delivery may take variety of forms like video lesson and online collaborative discussion, digital research, text reading, etc. So that which is traditionally done in class is now done at home, and that which is traditionally done as homework is now completed in class. This is flipped class. This meaning is given by Bergman and Sams. According to Smith, flipping the classroom involves pushing lecture material outside the classroom as a form of homework or other pre-class preparation, leaving more time in class for interactive or engaging exercises. Another group of people, they have said that it is the set of pedagogical approach that move most information transmission teaching out of class. Information transmission, classroom mein teacher dictation de raha hai, wo part classroom mein na cover karte hue wo student ko self learning e content diya jata hai. They study at home and use class time for learning activities that are active and social, jisme स्टूडेंट जो है दे विल पार्टिसिपेट इन स्मॉल ग्रुप टू सॉल्व द एक्सरसाइज. तो इसका मतलब टीचर का रोल बढ़ गया, ई कंटेंट भी बनाना है, वीडियो भी बनानी, लेकिन वो एक बार उसको अपडेट करते जाना है, लेकिन क्लासरूम में उसको लॉट ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ही हैज टू डू, क्योंकि उसको एक्सरसाइज बनानी है. स्टूडेंट्स कैन आस्क नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चन, ही हैज टू प्रिपेयर हिज लेक्चर वेरी वेल. सो इट रिक्वायर्स स्टूडेंट्स टू कंप्लीट प्री एंड पोस्ट क्लास एक्टिविटी टू फुली बेनिफिट फ्रॉम इन क्लास वर्क. सो फ्लिप टीचिंग इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ ब्लेंडेड लर्निंग इन विच स्टूडेंट लर्न न्यू कंटेंट थ्रू रीडिंग मटीरियल एंड वट यूज टू बी दी होमवर्क इज नाउ डन इन द क्लास विद टीचर ऑफरिंग मोर पर्सनलाइज गाइडेंस एंड इंटरेक्शन विद स्टूडेंट्स इंस्टेड ऑफ सिंपली लेक्चरिंग. In the literature, I have come across a number of terms used for flipped classroom, backward classroom, it is reverse instruction, flipping the classroom, or reverse teaching. So the traditional pattern of teaching is to assign students to read textbook and work on problems set outside institute while listening to lectures and taking test in the class. In flipped teaching, this is the reverse. The student first study the material themselves using video lessons, and in class they apply the knowledge by solving problems and doing practical work. Now let us relate the aspects of flipped classroom with Bloom's taxonomy. You see, students are given e-content and video to study themselves, to study at home. So at that point they are at the remembering part. Some of the students are able to understand the content if number of examples or illustrations are given. But in case students have got some doubt, they can seek clarification to make that that understanding complete during the classroom. So during the classroom, the teacher supplements the knowledge with some example. The students are given some exercises whereby they are able to apply whatever they have learned at home, they are able to analyze, and after the class the students are given some project to work in small groups. So evaluating and creating, they can be operated at that level. So flipped classroom is not just online video, as I told you about blended learning. It is not just reading or learning material. It is not just replacing teacher with video, reading or learning material. Teacher ko replace nahi kiya ja sakta. You see, instruction can be through a video, instruction can be through a lecture material or e-content, but in case the student has some doubt, he cannot seek clarification or further information. So that is why teacher's presence is required in order to clear the doubts of the students, or in order to clarify the concept or give more examples. So flipped classroom is not an online class. It is not where the students work without structure. You see, you have to prepare a lecture plan iske liye bhi. So the students are given the structure, and it is not where the students work in isolation. घर में तो ठीक है, isolated है, लेकिन classroom में they teach each other, they get their doubts clarified. And it is not where students spending the entire class online. It is a means to increase teacher contact time. टीचर का जो मैक्सिमम टाइम है ट्रेडिशनल क्लासरूम में, वो लेक्चर डिलीवर करने में आ जाता है. तो लेक्चर डिलीवरी पार्ट जो है, दैट इज गिवन थ्रू ई कंटेंट और वीडियो, दे कैन स्टडी एट होम. क्लासरूम में टीचर का कॉन्टेक्ट टाइम बढ़ेगा इंटरेक्शन इंक्रीज करने के लिए, और प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग एक्सरसाइज सॉल्व करवाने के लिए. सो इट इज एन एनवायरमेंट दैट इंक्रीजेस स्टूडेंट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. वो क्या है? They have to study at home. जो भी इसको टाइम मैनेज करेगा, ओनली देन ही कैन पार्टिसिपेट इन द क्लासरूम. इट इज ब्लेंडिंग ऑफ डायरेक्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन एंड कंस्ट्रक्टिविटीज लर्निंग. इट इज ए क्लास वेयर ऑल स्टूडेंट्स आर एंगेज्ड. इट इज ए क्लास वेयर एब्सेंट स्टूडेंट्स डू नॉट फॉल बिहाइंड. देखिए, कंटेंट और वीडियो आपने या तो व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप में दे दिया या आपने वेबसाइट पर डाल दिया, बच्चा एक दिन नहीं आ पाया, बट मटीरियल इज विद हिम. And it is a class where all students are engaged in their learning. So what are the advantages of flipped classroom over traditional method of teaching and learning? That is, a flipped classroom teaches students to take responsibility for their own learning. So with the flipped model, the responsibility for learning is placed on the students. So in order to succeed, student must take responsibility for their own learning. The flipped model creates a way to easily personalize and differentiate the classroom. So flipped model allows instruction to be asynchronous, so differentiation for each student becomes easily. Pace of class is appropriate for each student, and this personalizes the learning for each student. Flipped model makes learning the center of the classroom. So flipped class has become the laboratory of learning, where the entire focus is on what the students have or have not learned. The teacher provides them with all material tools to learn and support them by helping them develop a plan for how and when they will learn, and baki the rest is up to the student only. Flipped model gives students instant feedback and reduces teacher paperwork. क्योंकि क्लासरूम में एक्सरसाइजेस होगी, पहले तो ई कंटेंट दिया, उसमें प्रैक्टिस टास्क क्वेश्चन है और फॉलो एंड दैट इज फॉलोड बाय फीडबैक. स्टूडेंट को इमीडिएटली फीडबैक मिल गया कि उसका क्वेश्चन का आंसर ठीक था या नहीं था. इसी तरह क्लासरूम में, क्योंकि क्लासरूम में प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग होगी और स्टूडेंट्स को प्रॉब्लम दी गई, उन्होंने सॉल्व करी, चाहे ग्रुप में करी चाहे इंडिविजुअल करी, टीचर ने इमीडिएट फीडबैक दे दिया. और टीचर को बाद में, जैसे आप ट्रेडिशनल में तो वी गिव देम होमवर्क, तो होम असाइनमेंट तो कई बार हम चेक नहीं करते, डिलेड हो जाती है, तो वी डोंट गिव एनी फीडबैक. फ्लिप्ड क्लासरूम प्रोवाइड्स अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर रेमेडियल इंस्ट्रक्शन. यू सी, इन द ट्रेडिशनल क्लासरूम द क्लास मूव्स ऑन विद और विदाउट स्टूडेंट्स हु डू नॉट अंडरस्टैंड, and the pace of the class is set by the teacher, and it is based on the material that is to be delivered on that particular day. On the other hand, flipped classroom does not, you see, penalize slower students. Instead, the teacher give them opportunities to relearn and remediate. क्योंकि clarification उनकी classroom में clear होती है, डाउट जो क्लैरिफाई होते हैं क्लासरूम में. एंड वी दिस फ्लक्स क्लासरूम अलाउज फॉर मल्टीपल मीन्स ऑफ लर्निंग कंटेंट. वीडियो है, टेक्स्ट बुक्स हैं, अदर वेब लिंक्स टीचर हैज आइडेंटिफाइड एंड हैज प्रोवाइडेड टू द स्टूडेंट्स, एंड मल्टीपल चांसेस फॉर डेमोन्स्ट्रेटिंग अंडरस्टैंडिंग थ्रू वर्बल डिस्कशन, शॉर्ट वीडियोज, और डिटेल्ड पावर पॉइंट प्रेजेंटेशन, समरी यूनिट्स एंड सो ऑन. And it has changed the role of the teacher, instead of standing, you see, in the classroom, he stands in front of the classroom, tries to pour information, and becomes the center of the attention. Teacher spends the time doing what is most important, helping them, leading small groups in this case. It ensures that all students are involved, and it makes hands-on activities, more personal. There are certain benefits to the students, some benefits of flipped classroom to the teacher. To the students, the benefits include that they can learn at their own pace, and flipped classroom provides opportunities for review content. उनके पास है, घर में पड़ा, ठीक है ना. क्लासरूम में तो जब ट्रेडिशनल क्लासरूम में टीचर एकदम अपनी स्पीड में पढ़ा देता है, स्टूडेंट कुछ रिटेन करते हैं, लेकिन ई कंटेंट उनके पास है, टीचर क्लासरूम में सिर्फ ओवरव्यू देता है, मटेरियल इज रेडी एंड इट इज प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर एब्सेंटीज ऑल्सो, स्टूडेंट्स टेक ownership of their learning कि मैंने अपने आप पढ़ा है, and actively they participate with peers and do not struggle with completing homework because homework is completed in the classroom and under the supervision of teacher. And benefits to the teacher that now the focus is from guide on the side. Earlier in the traditional classroom teaching में his role is to act as a sage on the stage. But now his role is on to guide the students by being on their side. And teacher can spend more time for supplementing with practice, spend less time managing student classroom behavior, collaborate with peers in developing material. Teacher can connect with students and the teacher can is involved with student learning rather than mere lecturing. As I said that the role of the teacher has changed to some extent. So the role is that the teacher should be a content master. देखिए you have developed e-content, video record आपने कर लिया, आपने बच्चों को दे दिया, अब classroom में क्या करना है? So as a teacher you need to be proficient in your content area. So a teacher who is not proficient in his content area cannot operate in the flipped mastery class because students can ask number of questions, they can ask for clarification. So the ability of the teacher to move from one topic to another mentally is very necessary. So a comprehensive understanding of the interconnectedness of the content on the part of the teacher is very important. So teacher has to be a proficient knowledge of the content. The teacher must be able to admit when he or she doesn't know the answer to student question and must be willing to research an answer with the student. You have prepared your lecture well, even then some question comes to you for which you do not have the ready-made answer. Now what you can do? You can either address the question to all the students hoping that you might get some response from them, maybe some hint you can and with that, with the passage of this 2-3 minutes you can recollect. But in case you don't find any answer, so you simply say, wonderful question, I'll study at home, you also study at home, so tomorrow we will take up this question. Now when you enter the classroom next day, you need to first of all take up that particular question. But this should not happen every day. Ki aaj fir question aaya, aapke paas answer nahi hai, आपने बोला कि मैं इसको स्टडी करूंगा, आप भी करो. सो इसका मतलब मैंने लेक्चर को प्रिपेयर नहीं किया. सो इन दैट वे आई विल बी एबल टू लूज द कॉन्फिडेंस ऑफ माय स्टूडेंट. सो यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर योर लेक्चर वेरी वेल. द टीचर मस्ट बी एबल टू फ्लो थ्रू ए क्लास पीरियड इन ए यू सी नॉन लीनियर फैशन. You see, all these students are at different places in their mastery in the classroom and understanding of the learning outcome. So it is the role of the teacher to meet each student where he or she is. The teacher must be able to give up control of learning process to the students. They can study at their own pace. The teacher needs to play the role of a supportive coach. Teachers here are to encourage the students along the road of learning because students need a coach who can come alongside them and guide them in a discovery of knowledge. So teachers tell them what they are doing right and try to clear up their misconceptions. So instead of standing in front of the room, simply pouring the information and being the center of the attention. Flipped classroom has helped teachers doing what is most important, that is helping students, leading small groups, and working with individuals who are struggling. There are some of the research studies I have come across in the literature on the effectiveness of flipped classroom. And one survey was conducted by Chan, Louis, and Martinelli in 2017. They have examined 46 articles on the effectiveness of flipped classroom in medical education with different learning outcomes. And they have reported the findings in terms of the effect of flipped classroom, in terms of perceptions of flipped classroom, attitude changes after using the flipped classroom, and knowledge skill behavior changes with flipped classroom curriculum. So in regard to effect of flipped classroom, the review has suggested inconsistent findings regarding the effect, with some suggesting benefits while others reporting negligible improvement over traditional. But you can say that you see many good countries have started following flipped classroom because this has got huge benefits, that flipped classroom allows the student, as you know, to learn at their own pace, as videos can be watched again. It's more efficient as students enter the classroom, some prepared to contribute. Flipped enriches the lesson as more time can be spent on group work and projects, and doing homework in class allows students to help each other. So which benefits both the above average students and below average students. So some studies have suggested negligible benefit, but there are a lot of benefits. In regard to perceptions of flipped classroom, the studies have reported that students were generally satisfied with this approach, particularly the usefulness of online material because of easy access to resources for self-paced learning. In regard to attitude changes after using the flipped model, this survey has reported positive changes. Studies have suggested that medical students reported increased enjoyment, decreased boredom, and greater task value in flipped classroom. In regard to knowledge, skills, and behavior changes, mixed results were detected regarding students' changes in knowledge and skills with flipped classroom as compared with traditional lecture. Findings of other research studies using the flipped classroom to enhance English as a foreign language learning, examining flipped classroom in sociology courses, flipped classroom with and mind mapping, all in all subject areas, these studies, these mathematics research studies there, chemistry hai, then mathematics course, action research study for implementing flipped classroom model, impact of flipped teaching on student performance at school level in India. And basically the goals of the flipped model is to find an approach that would make it possible for teacher to move from sage on the stage to guide on the side, reduce the amount of time spent in class on lecturing, focus more on understanding and application than on recall of facts. This is only in case of recall of facts is only in case of you see traditional method, and while not sacrificing presentation of the factual base. Provide students with more control over their own learning, give students a greater sense of their own responsibility for their learning, and provide students with more opportunities to learn from their peers. So now coming to the implementation steps. Firstly, establish, you see, the learning outcomes clearly, and prepare a lecture plan. So determine which of these learning outcomes are best achieved through inquiry and which are best learned through direct instruction. You can decide. Then you can develop the content, or record a video using your own mobile camera. It is not now costly. So learning material, video content, self-learning, paperwork, and send to all the students in advance, or you can upload in the website of your organization or institute, and assure the access of all the videos and e-content to all the students. Okay, you can either send through WhatsApp, email, or you can also give them in a CD or DVD and so on. Incorporate engaging learning activities to be done in the classroom. So the student listen to instruction, interaction, discussion with peers, problem, question-based, experiment, experiential, debate. Create multiple versions of summative evaluation for students to demonstrate their mastery. And now they are using certain other strategies that can be used in class activities, like you see active learning, which allows students to apply concepts in class, where they can ask peers or their teachers for feedback and clarification. Peer instruction. One student can teach another student by explaining concepts or working on small problems. This should be encouraged by the teacher in the classroom. Collaborative learning activities could increase student engagement, enhance student understanding, and even promote collective intelligence. Problem-based learning, that is, class time can be spent working on problems that can last for the duration of the class, and then give students some opportunity to articulate their thoughts on the spot and to develop their arguments in support of their opinions or UC claims. Now, you see, let me give you some input about the development of self-learning material concept. Self-learning material is a method of providing individualized instruction in which student is active and proceeds at his or her own pace and is provided with immediate knowledge of result. So learning material, self-learning material will begin with a list of learning outcomes. Then it is followed by prerequisites, that is what the students are supposed to learn before reading the present module. Then the input. Input is presented in small steps, that is the topic can be broken down into say 4 or 5 inputs. Input one, simple language, because in textbook you will find very difficult language. Now here the language is very simple, and that is interactive language. You see, if a student reads the content, he thinks that a teacher is talking to him and not he simply reading out the text from a textbook. Yani jo language teacher classroom mein bolta hai, wahi language jo hai, wo humne isme e-content mein dali hui hai. Okay. So then interactive language, lot of illustrations, diagrams, pictures, or in case you want the student to view a video, you can give the web link of that video in the e-content. They can click on and they can watch the video. Then before the input one is finished, you have to write 2 or 3 practice task question followed by feedback to those questions, because it is self-learning. Then you will move to this input two. Again, the content, illustrations, diagrams, examples, practice tasks, feedback, input three, and at the end you give them a list of web resources available, or you give them the list of books you have used for developing the material. So self learning materials are basically learner centered materials, and open distance and flexible learner usually depend a lot on self learning material because they have to learn on their own at a time, pace and place of their own choice. So self learning material, if it is in the form of e-content or printed, we can call it as a module, and if it is presented through computer, then we say it is computer assisted self instructional material. Okay, now basically there are five characteristics of self learning material. Firstly, self explanatory. It means that the self learning materials are developed in such a manner that doesn't require any intermediary, that is the teacher, to explain the content. The content is written in simple language in small chunks, maine abhi aapko bola, to help students learn the content by reading and working through the instruction. Content is organized in logical and integrated manner. So we can say a teacher is built in into the text. So this is different from instructional manual that come with electronic gadgets or home appliances. The materials are explained with the help of examples, cases, and so on. Then self-contained. It means that the learner studying the material normally do not require additional material. Everything is contained. If you want him to listen to a video, then video link should be given. Okay, if you cannot draw the diagram, a very good diagram or circuit diagram, it is available somewhere in the web, you can give its link. So everything is contained, it is self-contained. The student need not go here and there to collect more information. It is self-directed. So you need to provide direction to the student to proceed and progress. So the material is directed towards learners and help them fit into their own style of learning. They are given necessary guidance, hints, suggestions, and are facilitated through access devices at each stage of learning. Self-motivating. As you know, this is the very important component of traditional classroom teaching, where the role of the teacher is to inspire the students towards acquisition of concept. So as such, teachers act as role models while learners generally try to emulate them. So teachers can create learners' interest and arouse their curiosity toward a subject. So such features need to be included in self-learning material. So as such, good self-learning material should create learners' interest, arouse their curiosity, inspire them towards the independent learning, inspire them to undergo practice task question, and inspire them to reflect on their experiences and practices, provide reinforcement, and so on. So you can include interactive mode of writing, you can include anecdotes, real life examples, illustrations, feedback on self-assessment questions. So these act as self-motivating means. Then self-evaluating. So every e-content must contain some practice task questions followed by feedback. So everything is, let me give you one illustration of self-learning material. Let me show you. Is this PPT visible to you? This PPT is on uniform and non-uniform velocity.
Yes, sir.
It is not visible.
I can see, sir.
Visible. So you see, I have taken a very simple topic, and this is a topic for a student of class 6, because you teacher are from different disciplines. So I have thought of taking one simple topic. Now, this is a self-learning material presented through computer. So that is why it is called as computer assisted instruction. Now, for developing computer assisted instruction, you need to know some of these softwares like Toolbook or Authorware, but these are very, you see, not easy tool to use. What I have done, I have improvised on PowerPoint presentation. And you know, in a PowerPoint presentation, if you click anywhere on the screen, you get the next screen. Or if you press any key of the keyboard, you get the next screen. But in a PowerPoint, presentation, there is one feature of locking the mouse and locking the keyboard. So what I have done is I have created button. This is a start button. Okay. So maine yahan par click kiya, I am not getting next screen. Now start. Now this is the first screen. It is written that at the end of this session, you will be able to, now learning outcomes are given in the form of general outcome and specific outcome. Understand the concept of average speed, know uniform and non-uniform velocity, understand the concept of acceleration. Then for each general objective, there could be number of specific objectives. And so here I am taking one example only. So I have not included all the learning outcome. Now there are three buttons, home page. You can go to the previous page. You can go to the next page. Now I'll move to the next page. Now, before understanding linear and non-linear uniform velocity, you need to know something in regarding the speed. Okay, so one prerequisite question is there. If your car is moving at a speed of 60 km per hour in first 2 hours and 72 km hour for next 2 hours, it means your car is moving with, okay. Say answer is the, so I have given four answers. So these you can select one answer. Say this is the right answer. Okay. Now you click. So your answer is correct. So you are getting a lot of appreciation. Okay. This has been taken from Google. So even the solution is also given. Now move to the next question. It is written here. This is self instructional. Okay. Self directed. Next, SI unit of velocity is, answer is meter per second. Say let us take this as answer. Your answer is not correct. So sad smiley. So answer is given here. Now you can move to the next question. Velocity is a vector quantity because it is determined by magnitude only, direction only, both magnitude and direction, neither magnitude nor direction. See, answer is this one. Your answer is correct. Velocity is a vector quantity because it is determined by both magnitude and direction. For example, this man is walking with a velocity of 2 km/h in west direction. Next. Now you get first input. Simple language. You have made different, you have used different font. Size of font is different in some cases. Purpose is to gain the attention of the learner. Now you can read it. On her way to Agra, Anjali travels by her car, which is moving at a speed of 50 km/h for first hour and 60 km/h for next hour. What is average speed of car? Well, average speed, the classroom teachers are bolte na. This is a new term for you. This is interactive language. Now you will study about average speed. Now the question which comes in mind is it necessary that an object covers equal distances in equal intervals of time? No, it is not possible. Dekhi, ye kitni achhi language humne isme create ki hui hai. For example, while traveling in a car, it is not possible to keep car at a constant speed. So it is better to express speed in terms of average speed. Now next. When we travel in a vehicle, the speed of the vehicle changes from time to time depending upon the condition existing on the road. In such a situation, the speed is calculated by the ratio of the speed, total distance traveled by the vehicle to the time, total time taken for the journey. This is called the average speed. So, अब आप इसको जनरलाइज कर रहे हैं, आपने इसको एक ब्लॉक में डाल दिया, उसको येलो हाईलाइट कर दिया, इस ब्लॉक में आपने ब्लू से हाईलाइट कर दिया, नाउ यू वांट टू कंक्लूड, आपने फॉन्ट उसका रेड कर दिया. नाउ नेक्स्ट, नाउ देयर इज वन क्वेश्चन, ठीक है ना, इतना पढ़ा, नाउ देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन. ए कार ट्रेवल 60, क्योंकि पीछे आप प्रीवियस पेज में जाएं, प्रीवियस पेज में एवरेज स्पीड का फॉर्मूला बता दिया गया है, ठीक है ना. Now next page में, a car travels 100 km at a speed of 50 km per hour and returns with a speed of 40 km per hour. What is the average speed of whole journey? Say answer is this one. Appreciation, clapping. Your answer is correct. Solution is also given. Now you can take an example of a car. ये इसमें ना क्योंकि मैंने अभी Windows लेटेस्ट वर्जन डलवाया, उस वजह से वो जो पहले वाले वर्जन में जो वीडियो था ना वो इसमें आ नहीं रहा, तो आई हैव टू मेक सम चेंजेस. सो अगेन दिस वन, देन नेक्स्ट, व्हाट व्हाट विल हैपन इफ कार चेंजेस इट्स डायरेक्शन. यस, चेंज इन डायरेक्शन विल लीड टू चेंज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द कार, सो वेलोसिटी ऑफ कार विल नॉट रिमेन यूनिफॉर्म. सो लेट अस थिंक ओवर हाउ कैन वी चेंज वेलोसिटी ऑफ एनी बॉडी. There are two ways, either change the speed of the body or change the direction of the body by keeping speed constant. Next. Now you can take an example. Two athletes, Ram and Shyam, are running with a uniform speed of 5 meter per second. Ram is running on a straight track. Ab dekhiye yahan par wo aa nahi raha. Maine banaya hua hai. So next, you see, now in this way, you will be able to, you see, then you will get the again one question. Okay, say answer is the non-uniform velocity, so you are getting stars. Next, this animation is working. Wrong answer. Now there is example given here. वो animation हो नहीं रहा उसका. Now you have one question again. The answer is this one. Is not correct. Now at the end summary is given, whatever you have covered. ये classroom में भी teacher कई बार करता है, at the end of the lecture he summarizes whatever he has covered. Then this is the last. Okay. So friends, now I finish at this stage. So now I open the session for discussion. If you have any query, you are welcome.
Yes, participants, if you have any questions, please unmute and ask. Sir, one question was there in chat box earlier. At the time of starting the session.
I think there is no question.
Could you explain synchronous and asynchronous once again? That one question was there in chat.
So synchronous communication requires real time communication between the presenter and the listener. That is through face to face, or it can be through phone also. Data transfer rate is very quick. Asynchronous is where the data transfer rate is less, but there is no requirement of You see between the teacher and the student. So वो virtual हो सकता है जो ऑनलाइन है, ठीक है ना, जो आपको मैंने वीडियो दिया, ई कंटेंट दिया, यू हैव अपलोडेड इन द वेबसाइट और यू हैव गिवन देम ऑन देयर व्हाट्सएप नंबर, सो दैट इज वर्चुअल
सर.
या
पर ब्लेंडेड लर्निंग, फ्लिपल लर्निंग इज द वन ऑफ द एग्जांपल्स.
हाँ जी,
लाइक दैट विल यू कोट सम मोर एग्जांपल्स सर.
So there I have given some of the models of blended learning. One is that face-to-face, rotation, flex, gamification, and whichever is very essential. Say gamification is a very important blended tool, a blended model for teaching management subjects where we employ more management games.
Okay, sir.
ICT, Information Communication Technology. Blended learning is information communication technology. You see, online, video, everything, content is there. Now, blended learning means blend of online and offline. This is blended learning.
Any other question? So I think, sir, there are no more questions. So let's conclude the session. So thank you very much, sir, for a very excellent session on blended learning and flipped classroom. Sir, you explored the benefits of blended learning, that is the combination of both face-to-face and online learning, and how it is more useful than we what various issues are there, then challenges, strategies for blending learning, and flipped classroom concept on benefits of the flipped classroom, and Bloom's taxonomy in context of flipped classroom, and the concept of self-learning material with beautiful slides also. So I hope the participants, being a teacher, will adapt this concept in their teaching learning methodology. So thank you very much, sir, for this wonderful session. And on behalf of all the participants, Engineering College Bikaner and Atal AICT team, it's my privilege to extend vote of thanks to Professor Sunil Dutt, sir, for very interesting and generous presentation. So thank you once again, sir. And
thank you.
Thanks to all the participants. And just we'll take a short break of half an hour, and we will be meeting again at 12 noon for the next session. Now my co-host Dr. Ritra Soni is there. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Professor Sunil Dutt, sir, for such a nice and informative lecture. I think sir has left, I think.
Perhaps. Yeah.
Anyways, so if you want to take a snapshot, then we can have that with the participants. So for this session, you can on the cameras. There was one query also, sir, for taking example for the school related. So that was an appreciation. Okay. So just a simple snapshot. Okay. Thank you, one and all. Sir, will you be meeting at 12?
Yes, 12. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.